So good afternoon. I welcome all the students from Goa and Lokmanya School for this session of NTS examination. I am going to cover some topics that are related with the physics. Of course, the extent of the syllabus is from 7th to 9th. 7th, 8th and 9th. All the chapters that you are going to learn in these three divisions, you are going to, the same questions will be over there on these chapters. Okay? So, let us start our discussion with a chapter which is called as a motion. Okay? Now, what is motion? That is the basic point. If there is a, if there is a change in the position of the body from one point to other with respect to my position, then I will say that there is a motion. Okay? For example, if I am standing on a platform and a train is passing over here with a speed of 50 km per hour, then I will say that the person who is sitting in the train is moving with a 50 km per hour. If some other train is passing over here with a 60 km per hour, then I will say that this train is moving with 50 km per hour while this train is moving with 60 km per hour. But then, if there are two persons, this person and this person, who are sitting in two different trains, he will say that this train is moving not with 60 km per hour, but it is moving with 10 km per hour only. Okay, because the difference will be taken under consideration, because he himself is moving with 50 km per hour, while this train is moving with 60 km per hour. So automatically the difference between these two speeds is 10 km per hour. So he will say that this train is moving with 10 km per hour. Instead of that, if this train is moving in opposite direction with 60 km per hour, then this person who is sitting in this train will say that this train now, which is moving in opposite direction, is moving with 110 km per hour. Okay? So, description of the motion will change from person to person. Okay? For me, this is 50, this is 60, and for this person, the description of the motion is totally different. So motion is basically a relative term. Okay? It will change from person to person. Now, describing the motion is, now you must have some reference point, and with reference to that particular point, if there is a change in the position of the object from one point to other, then we say that the body is in motion. Okay? Now, before going to discussion of the motion, let us define two important quantities. In physics, we are going to learn various physical quantities. Okay? And though all these physical quantities can be divided into two groups, they can be either scalars or they can be vectors. Okay? So what is a scalar and what is a vector? Scalar is a quantity which can be described by its magnitude only. So magnitude is sufficient to define a scalar. So it can be described with magnitude only. While vector requires magnitude as well as direction. Magnitude and direction will give you the vector quantity. Okay? For example, I can say that the time is a scalar quantity. If I say that 10 seconds time is there, then you understood by what I mean by 10 seconds. So automatically I just give you the magnitude and you will learn about that. So that is, magnitude is sufficient for a scalar, while vector requires magnitude as well as direction. And of course, we are going to learn something about the vectors in this particular chapter in detail. Okay? Now, After describing this, let us start with the motion. Okay. Now, there is a motion if there is a change in the position of the object from one point to another. Now, what is the distance? We say that whenever there is a motion, body covers some distance from one point to another. What is distance? The distance is actually the length of the path that is taken by the body while moving from one point to another, irrespective of the direction. Okay, suppose if you have traveled this particular in the direction say 5 meter, then this direction 4 meter, then automatically the total distance traveled will be equal to 9 meters. So actual length of the path that is taken by the body while moving from one point to other is called as a distance. Okay, now I want to define one more term, that is displacement. Okay, so what is displacement? Now displacement, whenever I am talking, then this is the first vector quantity that we are going to learn. Displacement is nothing but the shortest distance between initial position and final position of the body along with the direction.
Action
motor kaduka along with the direction. Okay, so displacement is nothing but displacement is nothing but the distance traveled, so shortest distance traveled by the body, or the shortest length that will be taken under consideration from initial position to the final position along with the direction. For example, if I move 4 meter towards from O to A and 3 meter from A to B perpendicular to each other, okay, then in this particular case the displacement is nothing but the distance from initial position to the final position and the shortest distance along with direction that will be indicated by this arrow. So OB will represent the displacement. OB will be equal to, by Pythagoras formula we can find out OB. OB will come down to be equal to 5 meter. So automatically the shortest distance between the initial position and final position along with the direction will give me a quantity which is called as a displacement. And displacement is of course a vector quantity. Distance that you are going to measure is a scalar quantity. And so that is about the two quantities which are very important one if you want to describe the motion of the body. Okay, now what do you mean by uniform motion? Okay, we'll discuss about uniform motion and non-uniform motion. Okay, so when we say that the body is moving in uniform motion, if it is going to cover equal distance in equal interval of the time, howsoever small be the time interval may be. Okay, if a body covers in the first second say 4 meter, in the second second, in the after 2 second it is at 8 meter, after 3 second it is at 12 meter, so automatically it is going to cover 4 meter in each second. So it, of course the direction is remaining same, so in that particular case we will say that the body is moving with uniform motion. Okay, and non-uniform motion, if a body covers unequal distance in equal interval of the time, howsoever small be the time interval may be, then it will be called as a non-uniform motion. So uniform motion, body covers equal distance in equal interval of the time. Non-uniform motion, body covers unequal distance in equal interval of the time. Okay, now we already discussed about distance and displacement. Okay, now the next quantity that are important from the motion point of the view is, of course we say we want to discuss the two important quantity. One is called as a speed and the corresponding vector quantity that we want to discuss is velocity. Okay, so what is speed? Okay, we say that the car, the speed of the car is 40 kilometer per hour. That means in 1 hour it is going to cover 40 kilometer. So what we are going to measure? We are going to measure the distance upon time, this ratio, while calculating the speed. So speed is nothing but equal to distance traveled upon time taken. Okay, speed is always equal to distance upon time. And of course, we don't require any direction to define the speed. When I am saying that 40 meter and time will be measured in terms of second, so automatically speed unit is meter per second. Of course, there are different units, there are different systems of units. I am here referring to the SI system or MK system, in which length is measured in terms of meter, mass is measured in terms of kilogram, and time is measured in terms of second. Say, there is a second system which is called as the C. So MK system, the unit is, or SI system, it is also called. So it is, the unit of the speed is meter per second. While there is another system, CGS unit, that means CGS system, in which the length is measured in terms of centimeter, mass is measured in terms of gram, and time is measured in terms of second. So this is another system that is used. Of course, there is a third system also, which is called as a FPS system, which is used by the British. That is, length is measured in terms of foot, mass is measured in terms of pound, and time is measured in terms of second. So SI system, the unit of the speed is meter per second. If you use CGS system, then the unit of the speed will be equal to, the distance will be measured in terms of centimeter, time will be measured in terms of second, so the unit will be centimeter per second. So that is about the speed. Now, what is average speed? Average speed is equal to, okay, so average speed is nothing but equal to total distance traveled upon total time taken. Okay, so average speed is always equal to total distance upon total time. Now, what is velocity? Okay, now I have already explained what is displacement. Displacement is nothing but the shortest distance between initial position and final position, and it is also the distance traveled in a particular direction along with the direction. So if you take the ratio of displacement upon time, because displacement is basically measuring the distance in a particular direction, so automatically if you take the ratio of displacement upon time, then we get a term which is called as a velocity. And displacement, since it requires the direction, so velocity is also, and of course the quantities which require directions are called as a vector quantity. Therefore displacement is a vector quantity, velocity is also vector quantity. So velocity is a vector quantity, while speed is a scalar quantity. So displacement upon time, displacement will be measured in terms of meter, time will be measured in terms of second, so unit of the velocity is nothing but meter per second in SI system, or centimeter per second in CGS system. Okay, so what is the average velocity? Okay, now average velocity is equal to initial velocity plus final velocity upon 2. Average velocity is equal to initial velocity plus final velocity upon 2. Okay, so we can calculate average velocity, we can calculate average speed. Of course, here I will take one of the example that is given in your solving sheets. I hope that everyone have got the questions that we have sent from our center. And the second question I will just discuss. A body goes from A to B with a velocity of 20 meter per second and come back from B to A with a velocity of 30 meter per second. The average velocity of the body during the whole journey is, okay? What is the average velocity? Now, to measure the velocity, you must measure the displacement, okay? When you travel from A to B, and back from B to A, okay? Then in this particular case, you have moved 4 meter in this particular direction, 4 meter again back to the A, suppose. Then in this particular case, you have returned to the original position. Now, therefore, displacement is the distance between initial position and final position. So automatically, in this particular case, the displacement of the body becomes equal to 0. And since the displacement is 0, velocity is also equal to 0. So velocity is equal to 0. Therefore, the correct answer is 0. But then, if you calculate what is the average speed, okay? So while going from A to B, I am traveling with 20 meter per second. And while coming back, I am moving with 30 meter per second. What is my average speed? Generally, students will just take average speed is equal to 20 plus 30 upon 2. Therefore, most of the students will write that the answer is 25 meter per second. But what is now, to calculate average speed, you must calculate total distance upon total time. Okay? Now, the total distance that you have traveled is equal to AB plus BA. Okay? But BA is equal to AB. Okay? So, total distance that you have covered is equal to AB plus BA. And of course, BA is equal to AB. Now, total time is different. Okay? Now, while going from A to B, I am moving with 20 meter per second. So, automatically, time required will be more. While coming back, I am coming with 30 meter per second. So, time required will be less. So, there are different times that are required now. So let us assume that time T1 is required while moving from A to B and time T2 is required to come back from B to A. Now you will have to calculate T1 and T2. Then only you will be able to calculate average velocity. What is T1? Now we know that speed is nothing but equal to distance upon time. Therefore, I will calculate first the distance required for moving from A to B. Let the time be equal to T1. T1 is equal to distance that I have traveled is AB. Speed with which I am traveling is equal to, so time is equal to distance upon speed. So speed with which I am traveling is 20 meter per second. So automatically time required will be T1, which is equal to AB upon 20 seconds. Okay? Now, I am coming back with a 30 meter per second and I am going to cover the same distance AB, of course, from B to A. So in this particular case, the time required T2 will be equal to distance that I have covered, that is equal to BA, of course, that is also equal to AB again. So AB upon time, the velocity was 30 meter per second, so automatically T2 is equal to AB upon 30 second. So you get the two values T1 and T2. Now we can calculate the average speed. Average speed is equal to AB plus BA upon T1 plus T2. So let us calculate the average speed now. Average speed will be equal to two AB upon T1. T1 is AB upon 20. Plus T2 is AB upon 30. So that is equal to 2AB. Of course, I will take LCM as equal to 60. So 60 will be the LCM. Here I will get 3AB. And here I will get 2AB. So that will be equal to 60 will come into the numerator, so that will make it 120 AB upon 5 AB. So AB get cancelled, so that I will get the average speed as equal to 24 meter per second. Okay, so the average speed doesn't comes out to be equal to 25 meter per second. That was most of the students will say that it is 25 meter per second, but it is not 25 meter per second, it is 24 meter per second. So while calculating the average speed, you have to calculate total distance upon total time, and the time you will have to calculate separately, okay, T1 and T2, and then you have to substitute the values of T1 and T2 to get the average speed, okay. So one of the important point that I want to emphasize is average speed cannot be equal to zero. Average speed cannot be equal to, you will never get average speed to be equal to zero, but average velocity can be equal to zero if the body returns to original position. Okay, so in that particular case, the displacement is equal to zero, therefore average velocity can be equal to zero. Okay, now we want to describe the quantities with the help of graphs. Okay, suppose that I plot a graph of distance versus time or displacement versus time. Okay, so I'll plot, suppose that the nature of the graph is like this, displacement or distance versus time. Okay, suppose that the nature of the graph that I have plotted is parallel to the time axis. Okay, it is parallel to the time axis. Then what is the conclusion that can be drawn from this? Okay, the conclusion is the distance is not changing with time. Suppose that the cluster is over here. Okay, with respect to me, the distance is fixed. And after 1 second, the distance is same. After 2 seconds, the distance is same. After 3 seconds, the distance is not changing. So in this particular case, the distance time graph will be parallel to time axis. And if the body is not moving at all, then we will get this type of the graph, distance versus time. Also, of course, you can, so that is about the distance time graph, if the graph is parallel to time axis. Instead of that, if the distance time graph is something like this, it is a straight line now, okay? Inclined to the time axis, okay? It is a straight line inclined to the time axis. Then what is the point that you can note from this particular graph? When time t was equal to 0, the distance travelled by the body was equal to 0. After 1 second, the distance travelled is equal to this much. After 2 seconds same, the distance travelled is this much. Okay? So, in this particular case, the distance of the body from the reference point is increasing. And so distance is increasing. So what we can say that the body is now in a motion, and of course its speed is increasing, because speed is equal to distance upon time. So if it is moving with some speed, then we get a graph like a straight line that I have shown over here. Of course, we can calculate the speed by using a quantity which is called as a slope. So what is slope of the graph? Now the slope of the graph is nothing but you have to take two different points on the graph. This is a, has a coordinate say x1, y1. So this point A say, this point B, A has a coordinate x1, y1, B has a coordinate x2, y2. Okay, then slope is nothing but equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. Okay, so y2 is the distance that you have traveled at this particular point. y1 is the distance that you have traveled after 1 second. y2 is giving the distance traveled after 2 seconds. So automatically, suppose this is 4, this is 8. Okay? Then the value of y2 is equal to 8, value of y1 is equal to 4. So y2 minus y1 will be equal to 8 minus 4. Upon x2 minus x1 is the corresponding value that you get on the time axis, which is equal to 2 minus 1, okay? Because x2 is equal to 2 seconds, x1 is equal to 1 second. So 8 minus 4 upon 2 minus 1. So that is equal to 4 upon 1, okay? 4 upon 1, which will give me the speed of that particular particle. So speed of the particle is nothing but equal to the slope of the graph, that is equal to 4 upon 1 meter per second. So what I can say, that I am moving with 4 meter per second. After 1 second I have covered 4 meter, in the next second I have covered another 4 meter. So automatically my speed is 4 meter per second. So in each second I am covering 4 meter. That is the conclusion that we can draw. So distance time graph, the slope of this particular graph gives us the quantity which is called as a speed. So the slope of the graph represents a quantity which is called as a speed, and that can be calculated very easily. Okay, now instead of distance, if you plot the graph of displacement versus time, okay, now displacement and if it is a straight line, say, okay, then what conclusion that we can draw in this particular case? Okay, so displacement versus time graph that I have drawn over here. Okay, now in this particular case, if you calculate the slope of this particular graph, okay, I have already explained how to calculate the slope. For that you have to take two different points, and displacement is nothing but the distance traveled in this particular direction. Okay, so here you are again going to get two different points. I can calculate, so slope of this particular graph, slope will be again equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. So y2 minus y1 will give you the change in the displacement of the body. X2 minus x1 will give me the change in the time, corresponding time that is over there, and slope will indicate the quantity which is called as a velocity. So velocity is nothing but equal to slope of the graph, that is equal to change in because that is equal to displacement upon time. So speed is nothing but equal to the slope of the graph of distance versus time, while velocity is nothing but the slope of the graph of displacement versus time. Okay?